Hi, it's Janet McHugh. Thanks for watching this next video that's near and dear to my heart. I'll be right back in 30 seconds. Bye.
I see I'm too late. Got nothing in my brain. That's what people say. That's what people say. I go on too many dates. But I can't.
Thanks for joining me. It's Janet McHugh. I'm here in my kitchen, not because I'm doing any cooking, not because I want you to see my dirty kitchen, or because I'm doing dishes, which I am, because I wanted to talk about something that I call, and everyone else calls, the elephant in the room. I think everybody has an elephant in their room, and so I went to my comfort zone, which for me is my kitchen. I want to talk about TBIs, traumatic brain injuries. That's the elephant in my room. I've had two, and most people, they look at me when I'm outside and they say, oh, she's so well put together and she's got her life in order, and that's all they see. People that really know me know that I forget words and I lose things in my head. I don't lose things for the most part except my phone in real life. I lose my phone a lot in my house because it's a black phone and I tend to lay it face down. But anyway, I digress. I lose words in the middle of a sentence. My memory gets jumbled. Patrick, my guy, calls it my filing cabinet gets out of order and just needs put back in place. And I agree, but there's still things missing. And last night I talked to someone I love very much, and that was just proof that my filing cabinet is still really messed up, and I realized that I need to talk about the elephant in my room because brain injury awareness is really important. I'm a survivor of two traumatic brain injuries. The first one when I was a child. I was, I believe, 7 years old. I don't have the dates and everything in front of me, but I was young and I was hit by a car in the snow, and I'll just leave it at that. But they did remove a piece of my brain right here. Anyway, I obviously survived that, and with medication and therapy and hospital stay and stitches removed and a bald head for a while, I remember the bald head and I remember the stitches tickling when they came out. And I remember driving with my mom to go see a doctor, but I don't remember the appointments. I remember those were like once a month or something, because I was a kid. So, yeah, I'm fidgety today. Anyway, I remember all that, and I remember hearing that it changed me. That was a big impact on me as I grew up. I remember hearing, oh, she's changed. She's not the kid she was before. That was a big sentence in my life that people don't realize. Oh, she's not the person she was. She's not the child she was before the accident. This isn't the same girl. This isn't the Janet that she used to be. And adults don't always realize the impact they have. And even teenagers don't realize the impact they have on a younger person's life. And even adults, when another adult has a serious injury to their head, you know, a traumatic brain injury, they don't realize the impact that they have when they talk about another person. But I recovered from that one. Your brain, especially when you're young, rewires itself. And I recovered to the point that I joined the military, passed all the physicals and everything. Woohoo, yay me. Anyway, I did that and had a really successful career, military. I was a district manager in the restaurant business, the hospitality industry, worked in hotels, really enjoyed my life. And then one day I got bored and tired of the names that people call the staff. Oh my God, customers are so rude. Don't get me started there. Anyway, so if I look down, it's because I gotta kind of put my words together. But I got tired of what people call people, and I just said, okay, I'm going to go drive truck. which my dad's a truck driver who retired. And I have cousins that drove truck, and both my grandfathers drove trucks, so it's not like it was totally unheard of. And I wanted to drive truck when I joined the Army, but I was told, oh, you're not going to drive a truck for a living. No daughter of mine's going to. So I joined the Army, because that's what you do when you're 19 years old and you're rebellious and you're the youngest. You're like, well, fine. If I can't drive a truck, I'm going to join the Army. You know, you. So that's what I did. But anyway, so then fast forward into my early 40s, late 30s. I don't know, whenever it was, I started driving truck. I just up and quit my job as a restaurant district manager and said, you know what, I'm tired of this. I'm going to go drive a truck. So went to class and got my CDL, and I already knew the basics, but you still got to go to school and learn it. Kind of like getting your driver's license for a car. So went and got my CDL and got a job hauling gas and oil, which they say you should never do for your first job, but I loved it. Absolutely loved it. Then we got a new boss after a while, so then I went over the road. I loved driving over the road. Now, if you're a truck driver, you either love it or you hate it. There's no in between. You either love being over the road and being gone all the time, or you hate it. I loved it. Don't worry, I'm getting where I'm going, okay? Then my mom passed away. Before my mom passed away, her and I had a lot of talks about me settling down again, because I had been married previously and she wanted me to settle down and find a good man and have a life again. So I promised her before she passed away that I would take a local job. And so I did. After she died, I took a local job. I searched. It took me a while to find the job that I thought I would like. And I took a local job, and it was a back-breaking local job. I hauled for a lumber company, a building supply company. I hauled a lot of lumber and shingles and doors and windows and did a lot of lifting. And anybody that's in that business is going to tell you it's not easy. I don't care what anyone says. When you unload your truck at every stop, and you pull those curtain sides, it's a hard job, but I loved it. I really did. And then one day on the way back towards the terminal, because when you unload, you reload, you bring back returns and everything else, guy ran a red light. He had a red arrow. I had a green light. I was headed south. He was trying to make a left-hand turn, and I don't know, he was in a truck, I was in a truck. For some reason, dumbass thought, oh, I'll just go anyway. And I was lucky there was a lot of witnesses. I tried stopping. We were on snow and ice. I tried stopping. My choices were limited because I could see on my right-hand side in the side road, there was a woman in a little white Ford Escort station wagon with a few little kids in the back seat. That's my pugs in the background out on the patio. I could see the kids in the carrier in their car seats. I wasn't going to try and go in that direction. That was obvious. And it was a split-second decision to stay where I was and just go as far to the right side of the shoulder as I could. And he hit me. He hit me kind of at an angle. He crushed my driver's door. He crushed my driver's fender, pushed the grill in. He was in a big truck. I was in a big truck. Things don't go too well at that point. Two big vehicles joining forces never does. So I went to the hospital and I recovered. Had a few broken things in my body, as I tell people. Among them, my brain. I woke up with an instant migraine. Apparently I'm the one that called 911. I always had my phone underneath my leg. But apparently I called, had the forethought to pick up my phone and call 911 and give them the location of the accident, and left the phone on. Don't remember that. Don't remember the cop knocking on my window. I'm told he did. And I'm told that I kept telling them to check on the other driver. The driver that hit me broke their pinky. I broke my brain. They broke their pinky, but So that's when my life changed. That was January 15th, 2009. Get my dates backwards. You know, things kind of get jumbled up once you've had your first or your second, in my case, traumatic brain injury. I know this is a long story, but I'm sorry. So life changes after you've had that happen. I went through therapy. It changed my vision. I can still drive. I still have good enough balance and most days to ride my motorcycle. I wake up and I know, okay, today's a motorcycle today, or today I'm not even getting out of the house, and today there's no way you could pay me to ride my motorcycle, and I don't ride behind, I don't ride bitch, as they call it. Just, that's not who I am, okay? I'm not gonna do that. That's my 90th birthday wish, and we're a long ways away from that. I'm hoping to have a trike by then. That way I'll feel better about it. But anyway, I go off in the left field a bit, so I went through physical therapy, and I went through emotional counseling and group therapy and more psychological counseling and more physical therapy and more vision therapy. Yeah, there's vision therapy. I didn't even know there was. And then I got special glasses. I know they look normal, but they're special. Anyway, most days I'm okay. I wake up every day with a migraine. I take all my pills. Between my vitamins and my pills for everything, I take 19 pills a day plus migraine pills. Like this morning, I woke up at 3 a.m. with a migraine. That's what woke me up. So I got up and I took a light migraine pill, the one that has aspirin as its additive. On a bad day, I take the one with codeine. I don't take those very often. I'm real sorry about the pugs in the background. They're adorable but noisy today. But everybody adjusts differently, and it's okay to be who you are with a traumatic brain injury. There's a snowboarder, Kevin Pierce. Have you ever watched his story? Watch his movie sometime. It's amazing. And now he goes out and he does these speeches. His brother helps him. I think at one point he had a nurse. I know I'm a fidget. At one point he had a nurse, and the nurse was there, or might not have been a nurse. It might have been a nurse's aide, but somebody. But I know his brother goes out with him on speaking engagements, and I've watched him on YouTube and watched videos, and he's very inspirational because he wrecked on a mountain back about a year after my accident. I want to say his was in 2010, and he paralyzed himself, I think, briefly, but he recovered from it. His injury, in my opinion, was much worse than mine. But every traumatic brain injury is like a thumbprint. Each person's brain injury is different. My first and second one were different. And they say my second one would not have been as bad as it was if I hadn't had my first one. Okay? I went to, I don't know, 4 or 5 different neurologists. Went through all these tests and they spun me in circles. I threw up on one of them. They spun me, strapped me down and spun me in circles. And I told them, you spin me in a circle, I'm going to throw up on you. And they didn't believe me. I threw up on them all over while they were strapped me down, spun me on this machine, and I vomited in a 360. I tell you, funniest damn thing in hindsight I ever thought of. If I could have done it on purpose, I probably would have, but to a different doctor. But anyway. So everything's different. My life is different. I used to just get out and do and go whenever, wherever, whatever I wanted, spur of the moment. Life is no longer spur of the moment. I plan things, and I've got family or friends that are like, why are you such a planner? Well, that's why I'm such a planner, because some people don't realize how drastically, two traumatic brain injuries has affected my life. I was called a faker. Now, I get that their insurance company called me a faker, but here I am, January of 2009, I'm going on 10 years, and I'm still waking up with migraines at 3 a.m. I'm still having a migraine every day. Some days are tolerable. Some days I'm curled up on the couch with my head underneath a pillow with the air conditioner high enough to keep me from sweating to death while I have a heating pad. Sometimes a heating pad helps on my head. Sometimes an ice pack helps. Sometimes I'll have ice on my eyes and heat on the top of my head because everybody's migraine's different. I'm not going to describe mine because I don't want some faker out there describing my migraine as theirs. Okay, so unfortunately there's people that do that. And if I describe my exact symptoms, I've already had one person do that. I learned my lesson. So I was already called by someone that I love very much a faker. Person did not believe me at all. I would say we went about 2 years without even talking because they didn't believe that my little accident caused another traumatic brain injury to me and caused me to be in such pain that I couldn't work. Just go find a job, Janet. If you don't want to drive truck anymore, just admit it. Go back into the restaurant business. If the stress of driving and being on the road is too much, just go get a job as a waitress. I never waited tables. I was a manager. Get a job as a cook, Janet. You love cooking. I wasn't a cook. I was a manager. Or you could go clean houses. You're really OCD about cleaning. I don't want to clean someone's mess up. If I want to clean up a mess, I'll let my house fall to pieces and then clean it. It's really that easy. And 100 other insults that I work really hard every day to forgive them for, because without even thinking they still say them, okay? It's just you, if you have a traumatic brain injury, this is where I'm getting at, you know, 17 minutes into this video, and I needed to put my story out there, okay? But if you have a traumatic brain injury, make your story your own. Realize that you're going to have good days and you're going to have bad days, but make the most of the good days. And those days when you're laying on the couch and you're curled up and you can't put your face on like I managed to do today, and you can't make yourself look decent and deal with people, fine, lock the fucking door and ignore people and just tell people, leave me alone today. It's okay to say that, okay? I wasn't aware of that. I have my guy, Patrick, who has a company called Hellraisers. I'm going to plug him today. Go check him out on YouTube and Facebook and everything else because he sells some really cool stuff, mugs and t-shirts and everything. But he's the one that really taught me that it's okay to not be okay. It's okay to be yourself. You don't have to please every single person. And when someone says, you're a faker, and when someone says, I don't believe you, walk away from them. Don't worry about their opinion because you know your own truth, okay? So let me hit pause a second. You don't want to see me blow my nose. Okay, I'm back. So, it's okay to not be okay. There's days you're going to have, like me, where I could cook for 50 people and be okay. There's days where I push myself. Like, Christmas season's coming. Yeah, I said it, Christmas. And I'm known for baking because I love to bake and I love to cook. And I'm going to knock out a piss pot full of cookies. I mean, I bake a lot of cookies because everybody that knows me, that's what they want from me is cookies. Okay, it's just really that easy. What do you want for Christmas? Cookies. So I bake and bake and bake and we send and send and send cookies to everybody. So it's it's not cheap. Ingredients cost money and they're time consuming, but it's worth it. But bottom line is, it's what I do, and I have my good days, and then I have days right in the middle of that where it comes to a stop and it's not a good day. And doesn't matter what my timeline is, doesn't matter what is expected, I just put everything on hold and I don't answer the phone for anybody but my dad and my guy when he's at work, and I leave it be. And you have to realize that you have to do that. And doesn't matter if you've got a traumatic brain injury or two or three or whatever you happen to have, do the best you can for you, okay? It's just like if you don't have a traumatic brain injury, don't try and please the whole world. That's the best I could tell you. That's the best advice I could give everybody. If just do the best you can do for yourself before you try and please everybody, okay? I've never put this out there in this way before. There's a ton of people that know me that have no idea I've had one traumatic brain injury, much less two. They simply think I retired 10 years ago because I'm made of money. No. Just so you know, Social Security disability pays squat. I make 1/5, if that, on Social Security disability of what I made driving a truck. But if you want budgeting advice, talk to me later. Email me. I'll put the link below. I found other ways to supplement my income with the help of Patrick. And I do online sales because you can walk away from online things. You don't have to go to a job. I have a very, very low tolerance for people, for crowds. And I used to be like the shopping queen. I could do Christmas shopping and crowds and stand in line, and I never on Thanksgiving. There's no way. But Black Friday, no problems. Now I don't leave the house on Black Friday because I freeze up. I freeze up in traffic and pull off the side of the road. Okay, they're called panic attacks, anxiety attacks, they're whatever you want to call them. I have them. And I have a lot of family, much less friends, that don't even know that. I take pills for them. It's a oral disintegrating tablet that I take. I don't take something that takes an hour to go into effect. If I had to sit on the side of the road for an hour waiting for a pill to take effect, cops would lock me up because I wouldn't be able to get my hands off the steering wheel. I'd probably get shot in the head with my luck. So, I have one that dissolves. That takes a few minutes, 3 to 5 minutes, 10 at the tops, and I'm semi-normal. I'm normal to the point that I can get out of the way. I've been at baseball games in line to get coffee, and we're season ticket holders for the Diamondbacks. Go D-backs. And go Cubs. Anyway, and had them open the main gates and the crowd of people rushes in and I'm just ready to order my coffee and I freeze totally. Can't even tell them what I want, freeze totally. But luckily Patrick comes to my rescue and kind of opens the little pill and says, open your mouth, and puts it in my mouth, and he orders my coffee for me and takes care of me, because that's what you do when you love someone. And I hope you have someone that loves you like that in your life. Because it's a game. Life's a game. You have to learn to play the game. You have to learn to coping skills. And if your coping skills is having someone that helps you cope, more power to you. Because I'd hate to play this game alone. I did for a long time. I coped with this injury by myself for, I can't even do the math because I have a migraine. From 2009 until 2014, 5 years, almost till 2015, real close to 6 years, I coped by myself. I did a lot of freezing up. I did a lot of laying in the dark on days when I didn't feel good and not even attempting. But I was blessed with friends who came by and walked my pugs and did that type of stuff. But they didn't know how to get me out of the house the way he does and get me to open up and talk the way he does. And I hope you have that in your life, because if you have a traumatic brain injury, you have to learn to talk. If your traumatic brain injury is so bad you can't talk, I hope you're able to type it out. If you're paralyzed, I hope you find a way to communicate. Communication is everything. I know my brothers at points wished that I couldn't talk, especially growing up. Well, unfortunately for them, I didn't lose that ability. That's a joke. Anyway, I think that's it, you know? I know that there just has to be good with the bad, you know? Two traumatic brain injuries and all the bad days and the way I feel today and forgetting what I forgot last night really hurts. And I didn't forget what I forgot last night because of anything except my brain injury. Because that's how my brain works. It's a filing cabinet that someone dumped all the drawers out of and then just shoved everything back inside. And my dates are all mixed up and sometimes they're not put back together yet. So, anyway, I hope everyone has a blessed day. Yes, I will get past this one. And now that I've spent almost half an hour telling you that it's okay and you're going to make it through the day. Yes, you will make it through the day. I promise, because even though there's tears in my eyes, there's a smile on my lips, because I do have so many good things in my life, and the tears will dry and the pugs will make me smile. And in a few hours, my guy will wake up for the day and he'll say, "Baby, why have you been crying?" And then he'll watch this video and he'll say, "Go, baby," and he'll give me a hug and life will be better. And we'll talk about everything and life will go on, because it always does. So have a blessed day, and I hope that you learn to understand, if you have someone in your life who has had a traumatic brain injury, maybe open up your ears a little bit to them and realize that what they're telling you just might be true when they say, "I don't remember," or "I can't," or "it's difficult coping," or "they're having issues." There's a good chance they're telling you the truth, because everyone's brain injury is as different as everyone's thumbprint, okay? Have a blessed day. Bye. Hi, it's Janet. Thanks for watching my one-of-a-kind video about my life story, about my TBIs. And if you're interested in finding out how I make money online, because I don't deal well with people in person, follow the links below. Thank you and have a blessed day. Bye.